Isn't he wonderful to us today? Good to be in the house of the Lord. Let us pray. Our Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Lord, that we're able to come and worship thee in spirit and truth. We thank you for all the blessings you bestow upon us each day. We pray for these needs that have been requested. Very concerned, Lord. We know that some of them will not get relief unless you help them. We pray that you touch their body, whatever their need might be. We ask you, Lord, to come and join us here in the service. Bless us and guide us and direct us. Help us to hear the word, Lord. Bless our brother as he brings the message. We thank you for all the ones that are here to play the music and sing. We thank you for each one that is represented here today. We ask you, Lord, to bless each one for their efforts. We thank you and praise you for all good gifts. In Jesus Christ's holy name, amen.
It's good to be here today. Thank you all for your prayers.
He is here, hallelujah. He is here, amen. He is here, holy, holy. I will bless his name again. Sense an awesome moving of the Holy Spirit. Oh, I see his countenance, oh, resting on your face. Well, I know that there are angels hovering all around us. Oh, the presence of the Lord is in this place. Oh, he is here, hallelujah. He is here. Bless your name again. Oh, he is here. Listen closely. Hear him calling out your name. Oh, he is here. You can touch him and you'll never be the same. Oh, he are standing. standing on holy ground. I know that there are angels all around. Oh, let us pray. Dream.
You may be seated. Brother Dwayne, would you have a song for us? And how about Brother David and Sister Carmen after that?
Good to be here this morning. One of them. Well, there are people almost everywhere whose hearts are all aflame. We'll defy that bell at Pentecost, which cleansed and made them clean. It is burning now within my heart, oh glory to His name. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. I'm one of them, I'm one of them. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them, I'm one of them, I'm one of them. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. They were gathered in the upper room all praying in His name. They were baptized with the Holy Ghost. Our for service came. Now what He did for them that day, He can do for us the same. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. They were gathered in the upper room, all praying in His name. They were baptized with the Holy Ghost. How for service came. Now, what He did for them that day, He'll do for us the same. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. I'm one of them, I'm one of them. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them, I'm one of them, one of them. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. Come, my brother, seek this blessing that will cleanse your heart from sin. And we'll part the joy bell singing, and we'll set your soul aflame. It's burning now within my heart, oh glory to His name. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. They were gathered in that upper room, all praying in His name. They were baptized with the Holy Ghost. Time for service came. Now what He did for them, He can do for us the same. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm one of them. I'm so glad that I can say I'm one of them.
Brother, all right, you may be seated. Brother David and Sister Carmen. And how about Brother Paul and Sister Naomi after that?
There's peace in knowing, Lord, you're in control. You got your hand on my life, you got a hold on my soul. There's joy abundant, I just have to tell. I'm drinking sweet water from your living well. When lost on life's journey, through valleys you'd lead. Lord, I know that you're everything I'll ever need. There's peace in knowing, Lord, you're in control. You got your hand on my life, you got a hold on my soul. There's joy abundant, I just have to tell. I'm drinking sweet water from your living well.
You're my shelter in wind, my cover in rain, my joy when I'm happy, my healer in pain.
You're my redeemer, you are my friend. You are my future beginning and end. There's peace in knowing, Lord, you're in control. You got your hand on my life, you got a hold on my soul. There's joy abundant, I just have to tell. I'm drinking sweet water from your living well. We're listening for thunder of voices to sound. When we get that message, we'll be leaving the ground. There's peace in knowing, Lord, you're in control. You got your hand on my life, you got a hold on my soul. There's joy abundant, I just have to tell. I'm drinking sweet water from your living well.
There's peace
in knowing, Lord, you're in control. You got your hand on my life, you got a hold on my soul. There's joy abundant, I just have to tell. I'm drinking sweet water from your living well.
You all for that. All right, Brother Paul and Sister Naomi and Sister Glenda and Sister Lori, how about you after that?
Once I walked in darkness, no sunlight could be found. Every day I searched for gladness, but it just was not around. Jesus shined his love upon me, and then I found I could go on my way rejoicing. I was heaven bound. Oh yes, I'm happy in knowing that Jesus is mine. I'm rejoicing, I'm singing, the victory is mine. I will never turn back, I'm on the right track. I'm happy knowing that Jesus is mine. when the storm clouds gather, no, I don't have to fear. For I know I serve the one who drives away the rain and tears. When the darkness hovers o'er me, I'll have good cheer. I don't worry, rain or shine, He's always near. Oh yes, I'm happy in knowing that Jesus is mine. I'm rejoicing, I'm singing, the victory is mine. I will never turn back, I'm on the right track. I'm happy knowing that Jesus is mine. Oh yes, I'm happy in knowing that Jesus is mine. I'm rejoicing, I'm singing, the victory is mine. I will never turn back, I'm on the right track. I'm happy knowing that Jesus is mine. Once I walked in darkness, no sunlight could be found. Every day I searched for gladness, but it just was not around. Jesus shined His love upon me, and then I found I could go on my way rejoicing, I was heaven bound. Oh yes, I'm happy in knowing that Jesus is mine. I'm rejoicing, I'm singing, the victory is mine. I will never turn back, I'm on the right track. I'm happy knowing that Jesus is mine. Oh yes, I'm happy in knowing that Jesus is mine. I'm rejoicing, I'm singing, the victory is mine. I will never turn back, I'm on the right track. I'm happy knowing that Jesus is mine.
Amen. Thank you all for that. All right, sisters, if you would come on. And how about Brother David and Sister Tina after that?
My chest had hurt about probably 5 days, and you know we have everything runs through our family. So I tease Lori and I tell everybody she's Nurse Ratchet. So anyway, she fussed, so I finally went, and they said probably just stress. I said, where in the world would anybody get stress? So anyway, I thank the Lord. So. Thought number one would surely be me. I thought I would be what I wanted to be. I thought I could build on life's sinking sand. But I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountain is too high, valley is too wide. Down on my knees I learn to stand, because I can't even walk without you holding my hand. I thought I
lot on my own. I thought I could make it all alone. I thought of myself as a mighty big man, but I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountain is too high, and the valley is too wide. Down on my knees, I've learned to stand, because I can't even walk without you holding my hand. I think I'll make Jesus my all in all from now on. When I'm in trouble, on his name I'll call. If I don't trust in him, I'd be less than a man, because I can't even walk without him holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountain is too high, and the valley is too wide. Because I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountain is too high, and the valley is too wide. Down on my knees, I've learned to stand, because I can't even walk without you holding my hand.
Thank you all for that. It's down on our knees that we truly learn to stand. When we're in prayer, that's when we get strength and grace from our God. Amen. All right, brother and sister. Happy birthday, Brother Dave, yesterday.
Always hoping we could hide behind little Finn this morning, but that didn't work.
Some lawyers can win, and some doctors can heal. Your old banker can lend till all your pockets are filled, but yours is a case of the sin-stricken soul. For the problems you face, there's only one way to go.
Just climb up that mountain where the still springs the fountain that sparkling crimson called Calvary's flow. That same Jesus you've heard of can take a black heart without love, wash it in red blood, and make it whiter than snow. Don't gamble on life with all your luck and your skills, 'cause you can't play the cards that death's gonna deal. For the Bible has planned who the loser's gonna be. There's only two winning hands, and they were nailed to a tree. Just climb up that mountain where the still springs a fountain, that sparkling crimson called Calvary's flow. That same Jesus you've heard of can take a black heart without love, wash it in red blood, and make it whiter than snow. So just climb up that mountain where the still springs the fountain, that sparkling crimson called Calvary's flow. That same Jesus you've heard of can take a black heart without love, wash it in red blood, and make it whiter than snow.
Thank you all for that. All right, I didn't give you much notice, but Sister Jessica and Brother Aaron. Thank you all for that song, and thank each one of you for your songs. Let us all stand, if we would. We'll turn the service over to Brother Allen at this time.
Good morning, everyone. Good to see you. Just thinking, sitting up here, the church is pretty well full this morning. And I appreciate each one of you. Appreciate Brother Punch being able to be back with us too. Lord bless our brother. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, such a wonderful day, Lord, that you've given us to be able to come together and to look unto you, Lord, the songs that have been sang. Lord, it's just a boost for the service. Lord, and for the preaching of your word. Now, Lord, we pray that you'd take charge of this part of the service and that you would guide my lips, Lord, into the things that I'm about to say today. May you grant freedom, Lord, that your word may go forth in power and demonstration of your spirit. Lord, we look to you because we know that we got but a short time here. And Lord, if time should last, it's still short. But we know, Lord, according to your word, that we're living in that final generation, the generation of when that you will come for your bride, to take her to be with you. Lord, there's some that are sick. There's some that are afflicted. Some desiring a touch of you that, Lord, they may be free from their problems and their burdens and their sicknesses, Lord, that's come upon their bodies. Lord, we are a fortunate people to be able to look to you in your word and to believe your word. Because, Lord, we are the body of Christ, walking here in this end time in a direction, Lord, of which that the outcome is going to be wonderful for your people. Thank you for these things now. And I pray, Lord, your blessings upon the remainder of this service. Lord, teach me what to say. Tell me, Lord, your word, your wisdom for this hour. And thank you, Father, for this opportunity. We pray in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you, Brother Bud. Just to be able to talk to the Father and to be able to express your desires and feelings to Him is a wonderful thing. This is a blessed time that we're living in, and a time that He has given us to be able to look into His Word, to
find His purpose for us. There are people here that have sat under the ministry of some Brother Branham, but most of you sat under Brother Jackson's ministry, and you have learned very much for the day and time and hour that you're living in. And what little that I can do to further your walk with God, I want to do so. It's not only a great privilege to be here with you, but it's a great responsibility. And you know, I guess that there's certain things that kind of hit you and stick with you whenever you hear something and all. And I know the song that Paul, Naomi, and Rebecca were singing this morning, that said that I'm on the right track. You know, I listened to them and I believe they believed it. I believe that Paul meant every word of that. Naomi and Rebecca all, they meant every word that they said in that, and it really felt it inside that we are on the right track. I have no doubt of it. I have no fear that we're not, because God promised to lead us and to guide us into all truth. Not part of it. I have been on this subject for some time now. I don't know just when it will end. But I have taken it from the Father's standpoint to the Son, of which that I had Brother David to make the circles to bring it on down to the individual, which from the very beginning of the Father is the creator of all things. Thank you. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Then in the sixth day of that 1,000-year period of time, which ended some 7,000 years ago, because God did rest one day, after that He had created the spirit of man, not the body, but the spirit of man. And when He said, let us make man in our own image. And then it said, in the image of God made He them male and female. Which, when Adam was created, he had both the male and the female spirit within him. Then whenever God took from him a rib with meat on it, He divided that and put that spirit inside the woman that He took from the side of Adam. You say, well, where do you get that? I get that from Genesis chapter 1. Because He said in the sixth day God created, He them, male and female, created He them, which was only spirit beings. Then whenever God made the body of Adam, and then He took from His side that rib, He took and made a woman, and He took that spirit from Him, placed it in the woman. And God knew what He was doing whenever He created them. And there's further things on that you can go into. But I wanted to leave that with you. Then whenever God, whenever man fell, God had already provided that spirit that would be in Jesus Christ. Because it said, in the beginning was the Word. And that thought of God, let me put it that way, that thought of God lingered with Him through millions and millions of years, till it come down to time, for the time for man to make his appearance upon earth. And in God's original six-day creation, man was the last one that was created. And why was that? The animal kingdom and all was created before man, because there was never man before that. All your animal kingdom had been before that time. So when God created man, that spirit of man, He created that last. But then whenever He put man upon the earth, after the 7 days after God had rested, then you begin this next 6,000 years. God creates man first now of all the animal kingdom, because He's going to be head over it. God made Adam to be a little minor god over His creation, because He's going to be the one that's going to rule over the animal kingdom. And that is still so today. You say, well, there are animals that kill man, but there is still, if there's not something wrong within the animal kingdom, your animal kingdom is afraid of man, because that fear is still in him of mankind, unless you've got a killer animal out there, of which that I want to bring this in because of the message. Because we see how that in the beginning God, that's the reason I made the bigger circle there for God, because it all streams from Him. And then whenever redemption time come, when man was up on this earth, he'd done been here for 4,000 years. God put His Son here and for redemption, not for creation. Jesus was not the creator. He never created one heaven, one earth. He never created any of that. He never created mankind, because it wasn't for Him to do so. Because then that would make Him Father, which He is not Father. Whenever it says in Isaiah chapter 9, where it says there, and that's, I went over that at the beginning of this message, where it says that He will be the everlasting Father. That is the Father living in Him. That's where the Emmanuel part comes in, is where that God with us, which God lived in Christ, God was in Christ, reconciling the world unto Himself. He wasn't here for creation. He was here as the head of the new creation, which is the church, which is His body. And that is more or less what that I will be dealing with today, is the body part of the Church of the Living God, which is the body of Christ. If any of these things that you feel that you have a question about after I get through with this, then you can write out your question. I will deal with that then, the Lord willing. It wasn't long after Jesus went back, after He had... When I say He went back, His life was... He said that I come from God and I go to God. His life, the little cell that was created in Mary's womb, was the life that come from above. I am from above. And that was Jesus' life, because there was no way that man could touch this, else it would be contaminated. But in order for Him to redeem, and this to me is a blessing, in order for Him to redeem, what did He do? He goes to the first one that falls, to the woman. And He places into the womb of a virgin a seed, which is to take the human vessel back to where that it should be in the very beginning, before sin ever entered. Adam and Eve, when they were created without sin, but they were created with the potential. And brother and sister, today, when God redeems us, we are without sin, because He forgets it. He places all of that on the devil that caused it. And some would not like that, But that's the way that it is, because that he remembers no more. And if we walk with him and we live in his presence, just as I was talking from 1 John last week about this very thing, it was John, 1 John chapter 4. I get to it in a minute here. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. Hereby know we the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God. And every spirit that confesseth not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. And this is that spirit of Antichrist, whereof ye have heard that it should come, and even now already is in the world. Ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. That makes him not equal to the spirit that is within you. The only way that he can get to you is our giving into it. Just because a thought runs through your mind does not condemn you, because you're still in this flesh. It is when these things are carried out. Jesus spoke of that. First it enters into your heart, and then into your mind, and into your being. Fornication has to begin with a thought. It begins with a thought and a desire that is contrary to the thought of God. And then it runs its course into the committing of the act. But it's first a thought. But the thing about it is, these thoughts can be overcome. And the thing about it is, even though the devil can trouble your mind, he cannot enter into it. Because it said, little children, you have overcome them. You've overcome the world through Jesus Christ. When Jesus was getting ready to leave, he prayed to the Father in the 17th chapter of the book of John. He prayed unto the Father, and as he was praying unto the Father, he said, I'm not of this world. And he said, these are not of the world. They're in the world, but they're not a part of the world. So we overcome our thinking, our desires, through the blood of Jesus Christ, because that covers everything. if we walk in His presence, if we live in the Spirit and walk in the Spirit, then there's no way that the devil can overcome that. Whenever you're a baby, you have baby ways. Paul, whenever he starts out with the Corinthian people, he tells them, he said, I've desired to give you strong meat, but you were not able because you're still babies. He didn't send them back to hell, but he said, you're babies. But by the time that he is through with 1 Corinthians, you see that this is for grown people. Because he was putting a pattern out there, telling them what that would help them in their life to become strong meat people. And to me, the way that the Spirit of God is working in this hour, as it comes from the Father to the Son and then to you. The Son is the channel of which the Father worked through for redemption. And we are the new creation because the thing about it is Jesus' blood, what He done there on that cross, was sufficient that we could become that new creation. So we are His offspring. Taken out of the wild olive tree, as it is in Romans, and taken out of the wild olive tree, we're put into the original olive tree. I'll read that verse again, that last one. Ye are of God. That is positive. Little children, and have overcome them spirits. That Antichrist spirit that is in the world. What is Antichrist spirit? Antichrist is more than denying Jesus Christ. Antichrist is denying His word. Because He and His word are one. You and your word are one. Let me put it in that way, because if we cannot be trusted with our word, then that puts a doubt upon us. But Jesus was true to His word. He said, when I go away, then He said, the Father will do the same works, even greater works than these. And I have some of that to get into here today, that I'm going to go to the book of Acts to do so. Ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater. It's not equal. That spirit that you have is not equal to the world. That spirit that you have is greater than the world. You understand that, don't you, Brother Mike? That spirit in you is greater that will overcome the world for you. Our weakness, and this is a hard saying maybe, our weakness comes from unbelief. What do you mean unbelief? It's unbelief is something that we don't feel that we are able to overcome. But this word tells me we are. The Bible was not made to be a hard book to live by. And you see the early church, how they lived, how they were persecuted, but they more or less laughed at that. Peter and John and the apostles, when they were hauled into prison, they walked out and went back and rejoiced that they were able or counted worthy to suffer for Christ. They didn't cry about it. They knew that they were able. Because greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. There's no equal. And what the Scripture is trying to tell us is that we can overcome. The weakest one in the body of Christ has a spirit in him that's greater than anything the devil has to throw at you. And the devil can throw a lot of things at you, can't he, Sister Helena? I always come in and tease her a little bit when I come in because I tease her a little bit and she begins to laugh. I like to see the smile upon people's faces. I want to go back to Acts now. Third chapter, starting in the 12th verse. Excuse me. And when Peter saw it, he answered unto the people, "Ye men of Israel, why marvel ye at this, or why look ye so earnestly on us, as though by our own power or holiness we have made this man walk?" Let us have our circles up here. See, we've come from here, through here, now we're in here. Because this is not complete until you finish here. Jesus' death would not have been important unless that he had somebody to die for. unless there was going to be a church at the end time. We look upon the church at the beginning as being something that were special people, which they were, but we see failures in them before the Holy Ghost come. But then when the Holy Ghost fell upon them, came upon them, you see a different people. And God's going to see a different people in us, because I know that there's something coming. We, as Brother Branham and Brother Jackson both said, we have not had our revival yet. And I'm not talking something that's going to do something to make people fall in the floor that they don't know what they're doing, or make people run and things like that. But God is going to fill His people to the point to where that they are going to be recognized as saints of God. This little puny walk of what sometimes that we have is going to be overcome. Because the same spirit that was in this, is going to be in this. That's what completes the body. And Peter and John had walked by this man that no doubt many times they might even pitched in a little something. But one day, they walk by because things have changed. They're different men than they were when they were walking with Jesus. They were in training then. Now then, they're in experience. They're experiencing what He said they would have. But Peter is saying here, and Peter, when Peter saw it, he answered unto the people, "Ye men of Israel, why marvel ye at this, or why look ye so earnestly on us, as though by our own power or holiness we have made this man to walk?" He has taken it all out of his hands and he's putting it back here. And that's what the Church of the Living God is going to do whenever it is complete. It's going to show here what has caused it to be here. The God of Abraham and the God of Isaac and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, hath glorified His Son Jesus, whom ye delivered up and denied Him in the presence of Pilate, when he was determined to let Him go. But ye denied the Holy One and the just, and desired a murder to be granted unto you, and kill the Prince of Life, whom God hath raised from the dead, whereof we are witnesses. That don't sound like a man that he did a few weeks before. Because he's no longer afraid and he's no longer denying who he is. And his name. This is where the scripture says that everything in heaven and earth comes under that name. And kill the Prince of Life, whom God hath raised from the dead, whereof we are witnesses, and his name through faith in his name hath made this man strong. The name of Jesus Christ, of whom the family is named by after they're baptized in Jesus Christ's name. And this was done, Brother Bud, this was done to a man who they knew. This wasn't somebody that had just been set out there to gather alms. He wasn't this man down here on the corner that stands there on the corner, "Would you please help me? I'm on my way to Indianapolis. Would you please help me to get to Indianapolis? I need some food." He may be, but this wasn't him. This wasn't a fly-by-nighter. This was a man that had sat there for years, and God had seen to it that they recognized him. "And his name through faith in his name hath made this man strong, whom ye see and know. Yea, the faith which is by him hath given him this perfect soundness in the presence of you all." Word, who got the glory for all of this? It was him. Because God named the whole family after him. When God gave Jesus the name before he was ever born, that made him different because God named him. It might have been an ordinary name, but whenever God names something, it is different. "Yea, the faith which is by him hath given him this perfect soundness in the presence of you all." This was not a made-up thing, as some have done in the past, put somebody in a wheelchair and paid them to get out of that wheelchair. Even Billy Graham admitted one time that their people that went up front for prayer was already Christian people. The only thing was, this was something to draw others to follow. This was not the case. "And now, brethren, I walk through ignorance. You did it, as did your rulers. But these things which God before hath showed by the mouth of all his prophets, that Christ should suffer, He has so fulfilled. Repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out. See, that's what I was saying earlier. That your sins may be blotted out. God's great blotter, which was the blood of Jesus Christ. And be converted that your sins may be blotted out when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. And he shall send Jesus Christ, which before was preached unto you, whom the heavens must receive until the times of restitution of all things which God hath spoken by the mouth of his holy prophets since the world began. For Moses truly said unto the fathers, a prophet shall the Lord your God raise up unto you of your brethren, like unto me, him shall ye hear in all things whatsoever he shall say unto you, and it shall come to pass that every soul which will not hear that prophet. See, we're back to the Word. Every soul that will not hear that prophet. And Jesus prayed in the 17th chapter of John, and he said, blessed are those that believe on me through their word. Jesus did not write the Bible. He lived it. And others wrote about him and wrote his sayings. And it shall come to pass that every soul which will not hear that prophet shall be destroyed from among the people. So you are judges today of what you hear. If it be true what you hear, then you are responsible. And I am responsible for what I say, which the responsibility lays in this area of how that we interpret what he said. Which in the beginning come from him. Through the prophets. He spoke through the prophets, but he said in this last days he's spoken through his Son. Now I will go farther and say, now in these last days he is speaking through his ministry, his church, the written word, which is interpreted by the Holy Ghost. Yea, and all the prophets from Samuel and those that followed after, as many as have spoken, have likewise foretold of these days. Ye are the children of the prophets and the covenant which God made with our fathers, saying unto Abraham, and in thy seed shall all the kindred of the earth be blessed. Unto you first, unto you first, God, having raised up his Son Jesus, sent him to bless you in turning away every one of you from your iniquities. Turning you away from your iniquities. So we all, whoever we are, we had iniquity in our life, but in Jesus Christ, this is all blotted out, our iniquities. I'm going to go from there to Acts chapter 4. I had a picture of Peter and John, which I should have already had up there, but I will go ahead with that now. Whenever the man was healed, as I said, everybody knew him, the people that walked by. But Peter, in this, whenever he asked for money, he said, "Silver and gold have we none, but such as we have, give I unto you. In the name of Jesus Christ, rise up and walk." And he reached and got him by the hand. That is faith. And that is faith that is going to work in this end time. I am standing here today predicting that. Don't doubt. Only believe. I'm not necessarily talking about this morning. I'm talking about from here on. Do not doubt what God can do. Only believe. I can't stand here and preach the gospel and preach doubt on what God will do. I'm not saying to this morning what he can do. I'm saying what he will do. We are getting foretaste of that already. In the fourth chapter, I'm going to go from, I've got 10 through 14, but I'm going to start on verse 5. And it came to pass on the morrow that their rulers and elders and scribes and Annas the high priest and Caiaphas and John and Alexander and as many as were of the kindred of the high priest were gathered together at Jerusalem. And when they had said them in the midst, they asked, "By what power, by what name have ye done this?" They're asking the wrong questions because they're going to get an answer. an answer they do not want. People do not want truth. They said, "But what power, but what name did you do this?" And they're looking at disciples that they think that they are going to scare. But the fright has already left them. And that's because of the Holy Ghost. They are not in it, no longer their own. Here stands ever how many of them they are before them. And they can't help but notice that they have, that things have changed because they have been with Jesus. And that's what we need to do in this hour is get with Jesus. See, they gathered all these dignitaries. The high priest and his kinfolks and Annas and all of these, they gathered them and circled the apostles because it said they put them in the midst. When I went to the Philippines with Brother Steve, Sister Elsie the first time, they had a lot of questions because there had been lies told. I won't get into that, but there had been lies that had been told. Brother Jimmy sent me a list of the things that he wanted answered. And we had two all-day services. And I mean all day, from 9 o'clock in the morning till at least 6 o'clock that night. In the last day of that service, there's some people there that had come more than 200 miles from an island. They couldn't get in the building, so they'd stood outside. I didn't know they were there. They stood outside along the building to where they could hear. And one of them come to Brother Jimmy and said, "Would it be possible that we could get in to speak to Brother Allen and to see them?" You talk about somebody feeling little. I did. They come in and I talk with them. We got acquainted. But the thing about it is, the questions that were asked, I preached on those things. And there's about a dozen preachers there. Brother Jimmy said, "I want all you preachers to circle, get in a circle. I want Brother Allen in the midst of them, that he may answer your questions that you have." And he asked them, said, "What questions do you have for him?" They said, "Nothing. No questions." I didn't know what they was going to ask. But the Holy Ghost will answer your questions. By what power, by what name have you done this? Then Peter, filled with the Holy Ghost. He is no longer speaking as Peter. He's speaking by the leadership of the Holy Ghost. And Peter, filled with the Holy Ghost, said unto them, ye rulers of the people and elders of Israel. If we this day be examined of the good deed done to this impotent man, by what means he is made whole, be it known unto you all. And to all the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom ye crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him doth this man stand here before you whole. This is the stone which was set at naught of you builders, which is become the head of the corner. Neither is there salvation in any other. And I will say that today to America, there's no salvation in any other name of which you don't want a name. You don't want to pray to him. Don't ever ask me to pray. I don't care who it's before. I don't care if it's before a bunch of Muslims or a bunch of Obamas. You ignorant and unlearned people, how long are you going to resist the counsel of God? This country was not founded upon unbelief. It was not founded upon principles that you are making it to be. You have taken religion out, and religion is nothing today. But you have taken the forefathers and what they believe. You've taken them out when every one of them, when 27 of them were preachers. Of the founders of the Constitution that wrote up the Constitution were preachers. You think you're so smart, but you're a bunch of ignoramuses. Because you think that you can make America a place of a playground of religion. Your Tom Cruises and Oprah Winfrey's, you are on your road to destruction. You've created your own religion and you've created a mess. Anybody that denies God and denies Jesus Christ, you're on your road to hell. Neither is there salvation in any other. Why is this Hindu religion in America today? Why is this Muslim religion here today? For there is none other name under heaven given among men. No other name given among men whereby we must be saved. That is it. I'm going to go farther. Now, when they saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were unlearned and ignorant men, they marveled. This is not coming from a bunch of learned men. This is all coming from the Holy Ghost, which they had received just days prior to this. And they took knowledge of them that they had been with Jesus. And beholding the man which was healed standing with them, they could say nothing against it. But when they had commanded them to go aside out of the council, they conferred among themselves, saying, "What shall we do to these men?" They had made a problem. For that indeed a notable miracle hath been done by them is manifest to all them that dwell in Jerusalem, and we cannot deny it. It's in their laps now. But that it spread no further among the people, let us strictly threaten them that they speak henceforth to no man in this name. And they called them and commanded them not to speak at all, neither to teach the name of Jesus. But Peter and John answered and said unto them, "Whether it be right in the sight of God to hearken unto you more than unto God, judge ye." There comes a time to speak against the government. There comes a time to speak against the leadership of a country. And they just answered them bluntly. Whether it be right to speak against, let me read that again. But Peter and John answered and said unto them, "Whether it be right in the sight of God to hearken unto you more than unto God, judge ye. For we cannot but speak the things which we have seen and heard." And so, when they had further threatened them, they let them go, finding nothing how they might punish them because of the people. For all men glorified God for that which was done, for the man was above 40 years old on whom the miracle of healing was showed. They were showed to be ignorant. They were shown to be fools for what they had done. I want to go to Acts chapter 5 now. Starting in verse 12. By the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people, and they were all with one accord in Solomon's porch. I can't tell you how important it is this morning to only believe. But we didn't come to Faith Assembly to play church. The unbelief must leave. If we're going to see the glory of God, we got to get unbelief out of our lives. And this is what that I want to see among us, is that God can work through us back to the circles again. Let's have our circles again, please. That God may work through this part just like He did in this part. It's no different. You come from here to here to here. It is no different. It is God in all, but He flowed through His Son. Now then, this come from here into here, just like that the vine in chapter 15. And we're getting rid of the unnecessary branches through the Word. Because the unnecessary branches is taken away from what that goes into here. Because this is only what is going to grow fruit. Anything out of this is going to be cut off. And God is the gardener of that. And He's going to see to it that this circle here is complete. You can only put so much in this, and the rest of it's got to fall off. They can't anything grow outside here. It's just like the tares don't go with the wheat. Let them grow together till the end. But in the end, they will be rooted up. That tare spirit can no longer live in this. Because it is harvest time. And I can see it today. I can see the natural as well as the spiritual. I can see Sodom. I can see Noah's day as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the days of the coming of the Son of Man. The Son of Man, when He's ready to come, He is Word. By the hands of the apostles, I don't want to doubt. I don't want unbelief in my life. I've seen too much. I've heard too much to doubt God. By the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people. They were all with one accord in Solomon's porch. At the beginning, 1906, you didn't want to go to Azusa Street unless that you were going to get the Holy Ghost. When these apostles, whenever they got together there, and God done things as He does in the fifth chapter there, after Ananias and Sapphira is killed, nobody dares to join them without the Holy Ghost. No unbelievers, but many were added unto them. And of the rest, durst no man join himself to them, but the people magnified them. And believers were the more added to the Lord, multitudes, both of men and women. Insomuch that they brought forth the sick into the streets and laid them on beds and couches, that at the least the shadow of Peter passing by might overshadow some of them. This did not happen in Jesus' ministry. He said, greater. Because it is Jesus' ministry. It is Jesus' ministry in this. You don't get outside the circle in the ministry of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because it's all in His name. They brought people on couches and beds, and Peter walked by, and when his shadow overshadowed them, it was not Peter's shadow, it was the Holy Ghost in that shadow. When he walked by, Brother David, when he walked by, they got up off of their couches and out off of their beds, and they began to walk, they began to leap, they began to praise God. Are you ready for it? It's got to happen. Unbelief can't hold it. Insomuch that they brought forth the sick into the streets and laid them on beds and couches, that at the least the shadow of Peter passing by might overshadow some of them. There came also a multitude out of the cities round about unto Jerusalem, bringing sick folk and them which were vexed with unclean spirits. And they were healed. The devils were cast out. Unclean spirits. People that had lived dishonestly. People that had lived in lust. Unclean spirits. You can't. These kind of spirits cannot live inside this circle. We get our hearts right. The message, brother and sister, is right. Yeah, I'm going to quit for this morning. Well, I'm on my way to Canaan's land. I'm on my way to Canaan's land. I'm on my way to Canaan's land. I'm on my way, praise God, I'm on my way. Come on along and go with me. Come on along and go with me. Come on along and go with me. I'm on my way, praise God, I'm on my way. I'm on my way to a better land. I'm on my way. Let David have this. I just felt like singing that. No use to doing something you don't feel like.
Get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, oh, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, oh, we're gonna have a good time. What a time, what a time. Oh, when all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. Oh, when all God's children get there, We're gonna have a good time. What a time, what a time, a mighty good time. We're coming up from every nation. Won't be no separation. Coming in from the north and the south. Well, away to the Father's house. Coming in from the east and the west. We're on our way to the land of rest. What a time, a mighty good time. Oh, when all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. What a time, what a time, a mighty good time. Oh, we're gonna walk down streets of gold in the homeland of the soul. Gonna view the host and wide, praise the Lamb who is the light. There'll be no separation. We're on our way to the coronation. What a time, what a time, a mighty good time. Oh, and all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, oh, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, oh, we're gonna have a good time. What a time, what a time, a mighty good time. Oh, we'll see our dads and mothers. We're gonna have a good time. We'll meet your saints and loved ones. We're gonna have a good time. We'll walk and talk with Jesus. Oh, we're gonna have a good time. What a time, what a time, a mighty good time. Well, when all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. What a time, what a time, a mighty good time. Well, when all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. What a time, what a time, a mighty good time. Oh, we'll walk through the streets of gold and the homeland of the soul. We'll view the host and wise, praise the Lamb who is alive. Oh, there'll be no separation. We're on our way to the coronation. What a time, what a time, a mighty good time. Well, when all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. What a time, what a time, a mighty good time. Well, when all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. What a time, what a time, a mighty good time. Well, when all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. When all God's children get there, we're gonna have a good time. What a time, what a time, a mighty good time. I said, if God be for us, who can be against us? Who can separate us from His almighty head? If God be for us, who can be against us? We can win the battle if for Christ we stand. Well, now Goliath stood there boldly, defying God's army. But there stood little David, but he did not stand alone. He said, in the name of my Lord, I come against thee. He slew that giant with a sling and a stone. I said, if God be for us, who can be against us? Who can separate us from His almighty hand? If God be for us, who can be against us? We can win the battle if for Christ we stand. Well, now the lions, they were roaring, fierce and hungry, but Daniel knew the one he served would bring him out. Well, the king said, hey, Daniel, hath your God delivered thee? He replied, my Lord, shut the lion's mouth. Oh, I said, if God be for us, who can be against us? Who can separate us from his almighty hand? If God be for us, who can be against us? We can win the battle if for Christ we stand. Oh, I said, if God be for us, who can be against us? Who can separate us from this almighty hand? If God be for us, who can be against us? We can win the battle if for Christ we stand. Well, now the lions, they were roaring, fierce and hungry, but Daniel knew the one he served would bring him out. Will the king said, hey, Daniel, hath your God delivered thee? He replied, my Lord has shut the lion's mouth. Well, I said, if God be for us, who can be against us? Who can separate us from his almighty hand? If God be for us, who can be against us? We can win the battle if for Christ we stand. Well, long years ago, when out of sin, well, I had no hope, no peace within. Down on my knees, oh, in agony, I prayed to Jesus and he gladly set me free. And I never shall forget the day, oh, when all the burdens of my soul were rolled away. But it makes me happy, glad and free. Well, I'm gonna shout it for it's everything to me. Oh, I never shall forget the day when all the burdens of my soul, they were rolled away. It makes me happy, glad and free. I'm gonna shout it for it's everything to me. Now I can feel him by my side. Oh, my feeble steps, he comes to guide. When trials come, oh, he comforts me. Through faith in him, over sin, I have the victory. Well, I never shall forget the day when all the burdens of my soul, they were rolled away. It makes me happy, glad, and free. Oh, I'm gonna shout it for it's everything to me. Oh, sinner, come to Jesus now. At his dear feet, oh, just humbly bow. Confess to him, oh, your every sin. He'll save and cleanse you, give you peace and joy within. Oh, I never shall forget the day when all the burdens of my soul, they were rolled away. It makes me happy, glad, and free. Oh, I'm gonna shout it for it's everything to me. Oh, I never shall forget the day when all the burdens of my soul, they were rolled away. It makes me happy, glad, and free. Oh, I'm gonna shout it for it's everything to me. Oh, I never shall forget the day when all the burdens of my soul, they were rolled away. It makes me happy, glad, and free. Oh, I'm gonna shout it for it's everything to me. Oh, sinner, come Jesus now. Oh, at his dear feet, just humbly bow. Confess to him, oh, your every sin. He'll save and cleanse you, give you peace, joy within. And I never shall forget the day when all the burdens on my soul, they were rolled away. It makes me happy, glad and free. Oh, I'm gonna shout it for everything in me. Oh, I never shall forget the day when all the burdens of my soul were rolled away. It makes me happy, glad and free. Oh, I'm gonna shout it for everything to me. Long years ago, when I did sin, well, I had no hope, no peace within. Oh, but down on my knees, oh, in agony, I prayed to Jesus and he gladly set me free. Oh, I never shall forget the day when all the burdens of my soul, they were rolled away. It makes me happy, glad and free. I'm gonna shout it for everything to me.
Glory.
As Brother Allen was preaching there, this country wasn't founded on Muslimism. And it's not going to depart in Muslimism. Israel is not coming here with Muslimism in control. She is coming here with God in control. Glory to God. God be glorified.
Yea, it is I, the Lord, the God that has visited thee this morning. Yea, I have sent that refreshing of my spirit upon thee. Yea, thou would knowest that I, the Lord thy God, am with thee. Yea, I say this morning, there is nothing that shall stand in the way of my people. For I, the Lord God, am here to deliver. Yea, I, the Lord God, will lead the way. For thou shalt not fearest anything the enemy would put in thy way. Yea, my servant this morning, he has stood before thee and gallantly expounded that which I have given him. My people, I say this morning, there is a true way, there is a true word, and there is a ministry that is pure in heart that will give thee that which is needed for thee in this hour. When thou comest this way, when thou givest thyself wholeheartedly wholeheartedly, honestly in thy heart, and say, I am willing to follow thee, no matter what the cost. If thou can find that in thy heart this morning, my arm is stretched out to thee, and I am saying unto thee, come, for I will give you rest, saith the Lord.
Amen. Amen. I know from time to time that some of the government might listen to our sermons because it's open to the public. And I want to say to you, if you're listening and you're a government official, judge ye whether it's right for us to obey God or obey you. You judge. We're going to obey God. Amen. Well, I don't really want to leave. Come back tonight with expectation. And pray for your brothers and sisters that are standing in need of prayer. Brother Turner, will you dismiss us in prayer? Yes, Father. Yes, Father. Yes, gracious Father. Oh, hallelujah. Yes, Father. Right. Yes, Father. Amen. May the Lord bless you.